Joining me now from Atlanta, Georgia, a member of the President Trump 2020 Advisory Board and Executive Director of NDC Trump, Bruce Lavelle. Bruce, thank you very much for joining us this evening. So as I was saying, a lot of moving parts going on this week. What is your big takeaway from the developments over the past week?
Well, you know, it's a sad day, Alex, and thanks for having me. You know, the thing that really disturbs me the most is the fact that, you know, the president is free to have conversations whoever he deems he has to. But here's something that I just want to, you know, reiterate on this, what the president promised from 2015 when he announced that he would not take any money from special interests, bad lobbying. He abstained from that. He wanted to come in owing no favors and do the will of the American people. Now, Alex, unfortunately, for generations, should I say generations and decades, previous administrations have wheeled and dealed and made deals with these other countries and other lobbying firms, et cetera. The president has the right to ask, and I do say ask whoever he deems necessary with President Zelensky, which you saw him saying he didn't feel pressure, he didn't feel anything, but the president needs to know that he has an open, honest dialogue with the new president of the Ukraine, so there's no conflict of interest. So if he's going to ask if there's some conflicts, he needs to ask that. Listen, you know, it has a very bad appearance of impropriety that Joe Biden's son, which is present on Air Force Two as he flew with him, and then Joe Biden say he didn't know why or heard or talked to his son about any of his dealings. You know, this smells very bad. It's unfortunate. But this is one president that is not going to be beholden to special interests and lobbyists, Alex, and this is a proof with this.
And, you know, I hear a lot of people, too, especially Republicans, that are coming out now and they're kind of defending the president against these allegations. Some of the arguments that I'll hear is that there was no quid pro quo that was, of course, promised when it first came out. I mean, you even have networks such as CNN reporting over the weekend that the whistleblower doesn't have firsthand knowledge of this actual information. So essentially, we're going off of hearsay at this point. But then I also hear that even overseas, the president almost has an obligation as the top law enforcement executive, the executive branch, to carry out the laws of the United States, saying that he almost has an obligation to ask Ukraine to carry out the investigation into Joe Biden. So how do you think Republicans should be handling it? I mean, I just laid out kind of a lot of the arguments that they are making. What do you think the best strategy for Republicans moving forward is regarding these allegations?
I think the best strategy they could stand with this president is, like I said earlier, he's not beholding or standing with any favors or pay to play. And, you know, Alex, if you look back at everyone that's got indicted or got in trouble, was something around pay to play or some kind of deal they were working on the side. This president is, if anything, Alex, he's coming in, he's losing money, you know, in terms of his business, whatever, because he's making a sacrifice. Others who go in and serve come out multimillionaires. And there's a reason for that. This president, once again, is not going to be beholden to special interest or to entertain any of that. The other thing too, Alex, a very important point here. This is a travesty. I'm gonna tell you why. This is a very conflict with our national security. We don't want our other leaders in other worlds, dictators or other allies, we don't want them to doubt our intelligence or our conversations with our commander in chief. You know, we don't know what's going on. We don't know, you know, the private conversations he had with Kim Jong-un to make him stop shooting missiles and to send those dead soldiers home, their remains back that have been held for 60 years, Alex. My uncle's friends could have been part of those remains that my uncle never got to see that was lost and missing in action in Korea. The list goes on. So this is a very dangerous, slippery slope. We have to trust our commander-in-chief. The people voted President Trump in by a landslide. And everything that he's done, he's kept his promise. And we need to stand fast on that. The other thing, too, is if you don't agree with what's going on as you're serving, by God, leave. You know, I never thought I'd say this, but I actually saw Philip Mudd on CNN defending the president and defending the intelligence community. I said, are you kidding me? Everyone listens. The Secretary of State, Mike Pompeo, a very well-decorated West Point person who runs the agency. These guys know what's going on, Alex. Let the president do his job.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.